Now we will discuss certain selected problems from exercise 10.2 vector algebra. Exercise 10.2. The first one is compute the magnitude of the following vectors. First one, A equal to I plus J plus K. A is equal to I plus J plus K. The magnitude of the following vectors. So here, A is I plus J plus K. That means this is the position vector of the point 1, 1, 1 in the coordinate plane. The position vector of the point 1, 1, 1. Position vector of the point x, y, z is xi plus yj plus zk. And also we know, so this is the point 1, 1, 1. And this is the position vector of that point. And this distance is distance between this point and this origin, that is this magnitude of this vector is root of 1 minus 0 whole squared plus 1 minus 0 whole squared plus 1 minus 0 whole squared, that is root of 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is equal to root. So this is root of 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is equal to root of 3. So this is the magnitude. So in general, magnitude of this vector xi plus yj plus zk is root of x squared plus y squared plus z squared. X squared plus y squared plus z squared. So here, the magnitude of the vector A equal to I plus J plus K is root of 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is root of 3. Now, the next is, write two different vectors having the same magnitude. Write two different vectors having the same magnitude. Write any vector in terms of this I, j and k. So, suppose we write this I plus 2j plus 3k, any vector. Its magnitude is root of 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared. Interchange any two this k's component. So changing I plus 3j plus 2k. This is another vector. Magnitude is saying root of 1 square plus 3 square plus 2 square. So thus we can have two or more vectors having the same magnitude. And now next is, write two different vectors having the same direction. Same direction. If two vectors are having same direction, they are said to be either collinear or parallel. Two vectors A and B are parallel, if and only if, one of them, say, can be written as a scalar multiple of the other. Scalar multiple of the other. And therefore, if we have a vector, so write any vector, say, I plus 5j minus 7k, is any vector. If we multiply this vector with a constant, so multiply, suppose we multiply with 2, or 3, or 5, or 10, any. Suppose we multiply with 2, then the vector becomes, the resultant vector becomes 2i plus 5j minus 14k. And these two vectors are parallel. Or, these are two different vectors having the same direction. Having the same direction. Okay. Next one. Find the values of x and y so that find the values of x and y so that 2i plus 3j is 2i plus 3j and xi plus yj are equal. this xi plus yj are equal. These two vectors are equal if and only if their component vectors are equal or corresponding components are equal. So we see that here, if these two are equal, then x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. These two vectors will have the other component, the set component also, which is of the form plus 0k. Here also plus 0k. So we see that here x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. And then the next one is find the sum of the vectors given three vectors. Say one, this I plus j plus 2k and this I minus 2j plus 5k and I plus j minus 7k. Find the sum of these three vectors. So adding these corresponding component parts are it. So I plus I plus I, so which is 3i plus j minus 2j, which is minus j plus j, which is 0j, then plus 2k plus 5k, 7k, 7k minus 7k, which is 0. So this is the sum of these three vectors. Corresponding components part added. And now next is find the unit vector in the direction of find the unit vector in the direction of the vector A is equal to I plus J plus 2K. I plus J plus 2K. Then here consider this vector A is a vector. If we divide this vector with its modulus, A divided by modulus of A, magnitude. So this becomes a unit vector. The direction is same as that of this vector. So if a vector is divided by its magnitude, we get a unit vector in the direction of the same vector. Here given this vector, A equal to I plus J plus 2K. If we divide this vector with its modulus, so modulus magnitude of A is equal to root of 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 2 squared, which is equal to root of 1 plus 1 plus 4, which is equal to root of 6. And therefore, the unit vector in the direction of this A is this A divided by 6, which is equal to 1 by 6. I plus J plus 2K. So this is the unit vector in the direction of this given vector. Now another one. Find the unit vector in the direction of PQ, where P and Q are points. Find the unit vector in the direction of the vector PQ, where P and Q are the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. So this is the point 1, 2, 3. This is the point 4, 5, 6. Now we want to find this PQ. Position vector of Q minus position vector of P. Position vector of Q is this 4i plus 5j plus 6k. And position vector of this 1, 2, 3 is I plus 2j plus 3k. So this is position vector of P and this is position vector of Q. Find PQ, which is position vector of Q, this minus this, find the difference. So we will get PQ. Then divide that PQ with its modulus. We will get the unit vector in the direction of this. First, find this PQ. position vector of point Q, which is this, this minus position vector of P, this. We get PQ. Then divide the PQ with the, its modulus. Root of x squared plus y squared plus z squared. We will get the vector which is unit vector in the direction of the vector PQ. Okay? And the remaining selected problems will be discussed in the next video. Okay?